In this vlog, we will try to see the difference between a stateless widget and a stateful widget. Yes, this might be sounding a very basic concept, but I'm getting requests from few people that to cover the basic concept as well with the advanced tutorials. So now today in this part of the tutorial, we will try to see the concept of stateless and a stateful widget. So now let's get started. So here, this is the code which we will see whenever we create a new project in our Flutter application. So you might be very much familiar with this coding structure here, but I am going to target the basic beginners, right? So I am just going to explain them once again. So this is our import statement and followed by the void main, and after which we are having a stateless widget implementation here. We are going to see what is a stateless widget and stateful widget. So this is a basic counter application which is been provided by the Flutter team whenever we try to create an application here. So you might have seen running this application and have gone through the output of this. So here the very first thing they have provided us is like a stateless widget here, followed by we are having a stateful widget. So you might be familiar with the counter example, but now let us try to see what is happening behind the scene of this counter tutorial and how we are able to increment the count here. And after which I will clearly explain you the concept of stateless and stateful widget. So stay tuned till the end of this tutorial, and by the end of this tutorial you will get a good confidence on the concept of stateless and stateful widget, and thereafter there will be no confusion for you in this particular topic. So here you can see we have got the output for our basic code provided by the Flutter team here. So whenever you tap on the plus button here, you are now able to see an increment in the count here. But by which particular widget the count is being incremented? Is it a stateless widget or a stateful widget? So now let's get started into our tutorial and see in detail. So now I'm going to remove all the code here, and I'm not going to consider the counter example now. Just we are trying to see another simple basic example so that it will be very much easy for you to remember the concept. So here we are importing the material.dart so that we can make use of the Flutter widgets. So void main, and here inside the void main I'm going to specify run app here. So inside the run app we are going to specify the name of our class, that is my app here. And you might also able to see a warning messages whenever you try to specify a different name over here other than my app. So why it is happening? So because inside the test folder here you can see there is a warning here, and inside the widgets underscore test here it is expecting a my app class here. So that's why we are getting a warning message whenever you try to make use of any other name instead of my app here. So now let us try to create a stateless widget here. So stateless widget, which is my app, and now here you can see there is no warning message inside the widget underscore test.dart file here. And whenever you try to create some other name here like my apps, so let's try to change fdware, and here you can see it is expecting the name my app isn't a class. So yes, I think you now got the concept why we are getting an error message there. So now let's get back to our tutorial here, and we have declared a stateless widget here. So to declare a stateless widget, we have used a simple way. It's like stless. So when you start typing stateless here, so you will be able to add a stateless widget to your code here, a default constructor here you can see. And we are now currently returning a container here. So now let's try to return a material app instead of a container. So by adding the material app, we can get all these things into our code here. So we can make use of all these components in our code here. And now within the home, I'm going to specify a scaffold, and this scaffold forms the basic structure to our application, where we can get app bar here. And not only app bar, we can declare the body inside the scaffold so that we can get the look of an application. So here inside the app bar, we need to specify the title with the help of a text widget. And here let us specify state. So just I'm specifying the title to be a state here. And within the body here, I'm going to return a text button for now. So let's specify a text button. And this text button will have again two requirements, that is on press, and one more thing is child. So with the help of the on press, we can just specify the functionality we want to be implemented when the user taps on the button here. And with the help of the child, you can just specify the text here. So within the child, you can just specify a text widget here. And now you can just provide some text over here, like I'm just specifying click, and you can make it a constant here, and you can just add constant modifier here to remove the warning messages which are being appeared onto the screen. So now let's try to add something to our on press here. So before adding the functionality to our button, I want to add a variable here. So now here I'm going to add a variable of type string here. So abc equal to default. And now we are going to make use of this particular abc and try to display the text default onto our screen here. So we are just having only text button here, right? So I just want to enclose it inside a column here so that we can have multiple widgets onto our screen. So here I'm going to add a text widget as well, and I'm going to display the variable abc with the help of our text widget here. So now let us try to run this code and see the output once. And here you can see we have got a click button here and a text view displaying default here. So now let's concentrate from here, and you can just easily understand the concept of stateless and stateful widget here. So whenever user taps on the click button here, currently we don't have any functionality here, but I just want to alter the variable abc and want to add a new text over here, like first app. So this is what I want to store in my variable, and this particular thing I just wanted it to be displayed onto our text here. So just I'm going to rerun the code. So here whenever I tap on the click button here, you can see there is nothing change in our text widget here. So in background, did the value first app is stored into the variable abc, so we are having a question, right? So now let's try to add a print statement and check whether the data is being added to our variable or not. So I'm just using a print statement here, and I'm going to test this. So I have just saved the code, and now let's try to. So here you can see we have got the button and default here. So now let us try to tap on the click button again, and here you can see our print statement is trying to print the variable which is having first app. So previously it was like default here, and whenever you tap on this particular button, it is being changed to first app, and the first app is being saved to our variable abc, but we cannot see it to be printed onto our screen here with the help of a text widget. So why? Because the main reason is we are changing the data and storing the new data into our variable, but to make the text widget refresh, we need to refresh the state here, and in stateless widget we cannot refresh the state. So yes, we are able to change the data, but we are not able to populate it onto the screen. So with the help of the stateless widget, we cannot refresh the state here. And what do we require? What do we require to update the UI with a new value which we are going to add to our variable here? So now let's try to add a stateful widget to our code here. So like the way we have added a stateless widget, in the same way when you start typing st here, then you will be getting a suggestions, and from there you can just select the stateful widget here. And you can just consider the same name like my app we have specified, right? You can just add the my app here itself, and whenever you are typing here, you can just observe where the things are getting changed. So here you can see here, and we are trying to create a state, right? So this particular state will be refreshed every time, and our new data, that is our UI, will be updated every time onto the screen whenever you try to make use of this particular state here. So here you can see we are still getting an error because we are already having a class with the name my app, so it's not going to accept the other class with the same name. And also, if you try to notice what is the difference between a stateless widget, like in terms of coding, so both are having a build method here. So in our stateless widget and in our stateful widget also, we are having a build method here. We are overriding a build method. So yes, you can just cut the code from here and add it to our new stateful widget here. So yes, here you can just add the code directly, and yes, this will work for sure. We need to have the ABC variable, right? So just cut the ABC variable as well and add it inside this state, my app state here. And you can just remove the stateless widget code from here, and now you can see all our errors are gone. Also, there is one more way of converting the stateless widget to stateful widget here. So now let's go back once again to our stateless widget and see the easy way. So here you can see it's already showing us a warning like the class inherits. The class is marked as immutable. So it is one or more of the instance fields are not final. So it is saying that the variable ABC is not declared as final. So now here you are getting an option like to convert to stateful widget here. So whenever you tap on this particular button here, our stateless widget is now converted to stateful widget without us doing any change here. So here everything is been converted to stateful widget just like we did previously. And now let's try to run this code. And now let us try to observe. And yes, we need to remove the previous code, right? So we have added a previous code here for creating a stateful widget, and we need to remove that and make sure you rerun the entire code to avoid any errors. And yes, here you can see we have restarted our application, and whenever you tap on the click button, we have got our print statement which is printing first app, but still there is no change in the text widget here. So yes, we have said that when we are using a stateful widget, we can update the UI, but still we are not able to update the UI. Why? So here it's a question mark, right? So there is a simple answer for it. Yes, we have considered a stateful widget, but we haven't asked for refresh. But we haven't tried to refresh the state. We have created a state here, but we have not refreshed it. And how to refresh it? So inside the text button here, just make use of the method setState here and try to add these things into this setState method, and now try to run this code again. And whenever you tap on the click button now, you can observe the change. Here you can see first app is being populated to our text widget. So yes, I think you have now clearly understood the difference between a stateless widget and a stateful widget. And Again, yes, depending upon your requirement, you need to use these two widgets. So whenever there is no change on your UI, you just want to move from one screen to another, just like a login screen. And there, I don't think you require a stateful widget to update anything. And again, if according to your design, I'm seeing if there is something design you want to update on your screen in the login screen, then yes, you can make use of a stateful widget even. And one more thing, why we have moved this inside the set state? Can't we add them away like outside the set state? And will this work? Of course, this will work. And now let's try to add something. Here I am going to add a second app and try to reload the code. And now whenever you tap on the click button here, the second app is being populated onto the screen, but we have not enclosed it with the set state. But make sure whenever you are calling this particular method set state here, it will try to refresh the state, and what are all the things inside the state will get refreshed. Not only this particular text widget, if there is any change in any other component, like any other widget, then that particular widget will also get changed, that gets refreshed. So yes, this is it for this particular tutorial. I just want to focus on stateless and stateful widget, and hope you understood this particular topic. And if you are having any queries, do let me know in the comment section below. And if you like this tutorial, do like, share and subscribe to our channel for more interesting content on Flutter.